LPA stands for lipoprotein little a. LP little a is a small cholesterol-rich protein that is made in the liver. And because it's small, it can enter the bloodstream, so it can measure your LP little a level. Levels of LP little a is genetically determined, so you are born with it. High levels of LP little a is common, affecting 1 in 5 people. That's 20% of the population. Studies have shown that elevated LP little a levels increase cardiovascular risk in the general population, and in particular in people with familial hypercholesterolemia. High levels of LP little a increases risk of stroke and heart attacks. People with elevated LP little a may have a 2 to 4 times increased risk of cardiovascular disease compared to people with low LP little a. LP little a is pro-inflammatory, pro-atherogenic, and pro-thrombogenic, meaning the arterial walls become inflamed and more susceptible to clot formation and therefore being clogged up. The structure of LP little a is unique in that it has a shell made of LDL cholesterol attached to a protein known as ApoA. ApoA has a structural similarity to plasminogen, the precursor to plasmin, so may therefore competitively inhibit the conversion of plasminogen to plasmin. Plasmin degrades fibrin blood clots, so with less plasmin to break down fibrin, fibrin levels increase, promoting thrombogenesis. Because of its structure, LP little a combines the atherogenic risk associated with LDL cholesterol and the potential thrombogenic risk attributed to ApoA. Most people have AP little a in the range of 5 to 30 milligrams per deciliter. Cardiovascular risk starts to rise at 30 milligrams per deciliter and rises more steeply at 50 milligrams per deciliter. Currently, levels of LP little a greater than 50 milligrams per deciliter is considered pathological, though this is a topic of debate. LP little a is not routinely measured. There is evolving guidance on when to measure LP little a. Do we measure it once in your lifetime, or only measure those who are at high risk? That is largely guided by what treatment is available, with the logic being that there is little gain in measuring something that we can't treat. There are currently a range of treatment options that are being proposed to reduce LP little a levels, such as niacin, lipid apheresis, or PCSK9 inhibitors. Studies have shown that statin therapy does not lead to clinically important differences in LP little a, so statin therapy will not change LP little a associated cardiovascular risk. I hope that was helpful, and thanks for watching.